Hey, I'm back. I'm doing the same thing I did last week. I'm going to give you a brief description of what happened, S.H.I.E.L.D., during the commercial breaks. Okay, this opened up with Talbot at the UN talking about S.H.I.E.L.D. and how they, you know, saved the Earth in the Avengers against the Tatari and all that. And, of course, then and the Italian guy gets upset, you say S.H.I.E.L.D. is dangerous, what proof do we have? And then all of a sudden he gets hit with something, a disc, and disintegrates. Okay, and then people start screaming, and these black-clad figures dressed like S.H.I.E.L.D. come in, and they start attacking other people and killing other people. And, of course, Talbot, you know, herds everybody out. And I guess the guy, lead guy there, says, this is what happens when you mess with S.H.I.E.L.D., you know, basically trying to blame it on S.H.I.E.L.D., because when we know that's not S.H.I.E.L.D., it's really Hydra. Okay, and then we flash back to the ship, and you see Ward exercising in a cell, and then you see Simmons and Sky are watching him, and she says, Simmons says something about every day, 5:30 a.m. He starts, even though there's no clock in there, no sunlight, he can't tell, but every day at 5:30, you know, he does the same exercise, gets up at the same time and does that. And, you know, Sky, and she said, and basically Simmons says, I don't know how you do it. And she said, well, she said, that's the cost of getting valuable intel, right? And May says, Simmons says, okay. And then you see Coulson walk marching along, and then you see Triplett comes along, and he said, listen, that attack obviously was Hydra, and now we have to try to, you know, stop them from doing this. And that weapon, and they said something about the technology. They have to go to Japan because there's a scientist that came up with that technology. So they're sending a snarky Brit guy, his Mockingbird, and May there to see if they can track him down. Okay, and they want Simmons to look at the hard drive that she took with her when she escaped from Hydra last week. Okay, and then also you see Talbot goes to visit a senator, and he's talking to him about, you know, and the senator basically says, this is out of control. I wouldn't agree to give you funding if you can't control, you know, you can't control S.H.I.E.L.D. And he said, that's time, I guess, we put him down. And he said, and basically Talbot said, listen, I didn't tell anybody about your brother. And he said, it doesn't matter. It's time to put S.H.I.E.L.D. down. And you see his name tag, and it's Senator Ward. I've got the first name, Christian Ward. Of course, the brother of Ward, you know, it's locked up. Okay, da-da-da, commercial. Okay, I'll come back. Okay, we're back from commercial. Sky's talking to Coulson, saying, listen, I'll talk to Ward and see if he can have any intel on his brother. And he says, okay, be careful and stay on point and focus, keep the focus on him, not, you know, not on your family. That's, you know, the alien technology thing to the back burner. She says, okay, she goes. And then Simmons goes and sees Fitz, who's sitting in a chair kind of mumbling. And she's saying, listen, that this hard drive I stole from when I escaped from Hydra, it's kind of damaged. We need you to fix it. And I need to have your help. And he says, okay. And then he proceeds to try to open it and starts mentioning things, but she kind of jumps the gun and start mentioning things, and then he kind of cuts her off and tells, listen, okay, this is the thing we should look at. And you can tell, like I say, he can't, you know, it's hard for him to say the name of it, but she knows what he means, and, you know, it's rough to, for her to see him like that. And then we go back down, and Sky is talking to Ward again, and then she's saying, we need intel on your brother. And he says, which one? He said, your older brother, Christian. And she said, stay away from him. He's always Alpha Angle, does he know I'm here? And she says, no, this is not about you. And he says, listen, I promise you, I would never lie to you. And I said, but my brother's always got an angle, okay? You know, he basically, you know, then she says, listen, you didn't tell me my father was a murderer, okay? Okay, so she kind of gets angry at him, and then, of course, Coulson comes in and cuts it off, you know, closes the cell. And tells Sky, yeah, he gave, she said, he didn't give me any intel. He said, yeah, he did, more than you think, but you got to stay focused, okay? Okay, and then they switch back to May, snarky British guy, and Mockingbird, who was in Japan, and it seemed to, you know, the Japanese guy who has the weapons that were used in the UN attack. And, of course, then they, you know, May said, we got two options. One option, we engage them and you know, and result in a firefight until we get, you know, until they bring out the bigger guns, or we can send Mockingbird and maybe her cover, even though her cover might be blown, because she knows Japanese guy, so we'll send her in. Okay, and Snarky Brisk guy says, you know, says something smart about her being good at deception, you know, and that, you know, not in a, you know, not a bad way, but in a good way. And then she goes and she greets him, and then she starts to kiss him, and then it goes off. And then, of course, Snarky British Guy, of course, and then May smiles at that, and then that's the end of that commercial. I'll be back. Okay, we're back. Mockingbird's undercover, of course, and she's talking to the, you know, the Japanese guy, and talking about eight past missions and stuff and all this other crap. And then, of course, Snarky British Guy is talking to May and saying how good she is and all this other crap, you know, the banter back and forth. And then, of course, they get an incoming message saying that they have video of Mockingbird escaping with Simmons, and that's about the message is getting ready to get relayed to the Japanese guy. But, and this guy walking up on Mockingbird getting ready to shoot her, and then, of course, Snarky British Guy shows up, and him and May, they take out the people. Okay, and then, of course, Snarky British Guy and Mockingbird proceed to argue with each other, which is becoming really old and not funny at all. And then we switch back to the lab where Simmons is, Fitz is focused on one, this one image, and he's trying to explain to Simmons about it. And then he kind of takes it out on her, saying, basically, you left. You know, you left me. Okay. And you can tell Simmons wants to say, no, I didn't leave you. It was another reason. You can tell that she has all this emotion put up, but then she says she can't do it, and then she walks away. And then you see Mac in the background, looking at Fitz. And then you have Coulson visiting Ward's brother, Senator. And, of course, you know, they trade, you know, the insults back and forth. And then, of course, Coulson tells him about how Ward told him that he was a psychopath who made him torture his little brother. Okay, and then, of course, Senator explains basically to Coulson that, listen, that's a lie. Grant is the master of lies and stuff. I've spent my whole life trying to, you know, cover up his lies, okay, trying to unravel them. And at the same time, you see Ward is talking with Sky, who comes back down there, and she's talked to him, and he's basically explaining to him about her father, how his family got slaughtered, and that he slaughtered this whole village, and that he could take him, you know, that he can lead her, you know, to her father, you know. And then Sky drops the bomb saying, thank you for telling me everything you know. We're going to transfer you to your brother, custody to your brother. And you see the look on Ward's face like, holy crap, that's the last thing he wants. Commercial break. Okay, I'm back. I forgot to mention in the last segment, after a Snarky British Guy and Mockingbird and May tuck out the Japanese guy and his henchmen, the next thing was to go to, I think, Switzerland to find out where this UN representative for peace is gonna be at. They think Hydra is targeting him to kill him. And then once they kill him, posing as S.H.I.E.L.D., as the phony S.H.I.E.L.D., you know, that'll get everybody, that's the peaceful countries, on board with coming after S.H.I.E.L.D. Okay, and now you see Coulson is talking to Ward again. He's basically, you know, telling him we're going to give you up to your, you know, to your brother. And then, of course, Ward is indignant. He said, was this your idea or his idea? He said, I thought it was valuable. I was giving you intel. And then that's when Coulson goes off and basically tells him, you drop Simmons and Fitz into on the ocean. You killed Agent Hand and I got the other guy you killed. He said, yeah, you're never going to see Sky again. But he basically tells him. And you see that look on his face, a little bit of fear. You see fear in Ward. Okay, and then you find out when they do intel that Simmons has Fitz and Mac have cracked the code on that hard drive, and they find out that there's a relative, I guess the grandfather of the scientist that created that technology. He looks just like the peaceful representative for the UN. And then that's when they find a connection between Hydra, and they find out, no, Hydra just did it as a diversion. They're really going to the safe house to kill more S.H.I.E.L.D. agents, okay? And so then S.H.I.E.L.D. has to get race there, but by the time they don't show them getting there in time. And the an agent that Coulson talked to in the beginning of the episode, she's there with the peaceful representative there, who basically just says, I just followed you here. And then you see that, you know, the phony S.H.I.E.L.D. agents, they come out And then he said, I'll leave you to, you know, do what you do best, you know, Hydra. And then he walks out, and then you see the Hydra guy, he stabs her with the technology that this disintegrates her. And before she dies, she said, you'll never defeat, you know, S.H.I.E.L.D., and then she disintegrates. And that's where it cuts off. And now we're waiting for the May and Snarky British Guy and Mockingbird to make it to the safe house, and they'll find the dead bodies and everything else. We'll come back. Okay, we're back. After May and Mockingbird and Snarky British Guy, you know, defeated Hydra, of course, and they caught the fake UN guy at the border. Snarky British Guy decides to say he's going to go off on his own, saying that the S.H.I.E.L.D. is more Mockingbird style, and then she kind of says, okay, good luck, if you want to leave, you know, kind of leaving like that. So I don't think Snarky British Guy is gone for good. Anyway, now we go back to Coulson is handing over a Ward, telling him to say, you're never going to see Sky again, okay? And at the same time, Ward's brother is, you know, giving the speech, saying, Talbot showed up to take away the bad Hydra guys, and she said, how many you got? He basically tells May, you know, kind of reach a detente and said, you know, you lost six guys, right? And then they kind of shake hands, and, you know, he's called, Talbot says, it's always a bad thing when you lose good men. Of course, they shake hands and go off. And then, like I said, you see, at the same time, the senator is giving a speech saying how evil is evil and stuff, you know, the Hydra is the evil side of S.H.I.E.L.D., and now he had evil in his own family, and he's going to tell his story about his brother, you know, about Ward, you know, working for Hydra and stuff, and at the same time you see them leading Ward off, you know, handcuffed, and he's leading him down a path, and he tries to say something to Sky, and no, he actually passes by Triplet first, then he passes by Fitz, who doesn't really look at him, and then you see Sky and Simmons are together. He tries to say something to Sky, and then Simmons says, "Oh, if I ever see you again, I'll kill you." Which, come on, Simmons, please. And you know, Ward goes off, and he calls and tells the guards, "Don't give him one inch, okay?" And then you see him get into the back of the van, of course, They give him one inch, and he slips out of his handcuffs and beats the crap out of people. So, you know, he's going to be on the run, basically. Ward is free. Okay. And then it goes off. Actually, it comes back. But then they show, the, you know, a sneak peek from the Avengers 2, you know, where basically they show the Avengers, I guess, sitting around trying to lift Thor's hammer and stuff. And then it leads into the trailer, the teaser trailer that you see where Ultron comes out, saying there's no strings on me, and they show the trailer. Okay. And then they come back from commercial, and then they basically see a guy saying, he said, you finally got money? He said, yeah, I got the money. And he gives the guy the money, and it's a tattoo parlor. And he said, you sure you want to do this now? He said, you know, it's not probably healed yet. And he said, no, I'll do it, you know. And he says, the pain makes me remember. And he has all that weird alien writing on him. And then it goes off. And then you have to wait 2 weeks for another Agent of S.H.I.E.L.D. episode. So that's my second live version. Let me know what you think of it. Okay, I'm going to edit this together. And feel free to leave comments down below. And this is Trepacer saying so long, and take care.